Good morning, children. Welcome to another class of biology. We had started with the chapter leaf. I completed two video lessons with you on this chapter leaf, and this is the part third. Okay, this is part three of this chapter. Now, children, we have completed the main portion of the chapter, but in this video lesson, I will be mainly talking about two activities, okay? Activity 3 and activity 4, which are more important and you have to understand those, okay? Questions can come, though all the activities you should go through once, but these two are a bit tougher, so I'll discuss these two. And rest I have already discussed along with the, when I was going through the chapter, that time only I discussed about this tendrils as well as that is activity 5, and about cactus also I had discussed, okay, prickly pear. So I'll be discussing these and some of the exercise questions, the objective ones we'll discuss, okay. Now first activity 3. Now what does this activity 3 is all about? Now to study the process of photosynthesis in the leaf, okay, we have to study the process of photosynthesis in the leaf. How we know that photosynthesis has occurred in leaf? Now what this method is, remove a green leaf from the plant and place the leaf in a big boiling tube. You can see that it is placed in a big boiling tube containing alcohol, okay, in it. Now place this tube in the beaker containing water as shown in the figure. Boil it on a low flame till the green color comes out of the alcohol in the test tube. Now what we have done, in this process has been done, let's see that alcohol which is there in the beaker, the alcohol which is there in the test tube, the small elongated one in the test tube where the leaf is there, it is not directly heated under the flame, okay. It is, the water is heated in the beaker, you can see, and in that the alcohol along with the leaf is put there, okay, to get it heated. And why it is heated? To remove the green color, that is to remove the chlorophyll, okay, which is there in the leaf. Now what is done, take out the leaf and wash it in water, put it in a petri dish. You can see a flat spray like thing is there, which is called the petri dish, and pour some iodine solution over it. Over that some iodine solution is put, okay. Now what we do, what we observe, okay, it can be observed that iodine gives blue-black color indicating the presence of starch in the leaf. Now what this does this observation mean, okay? First and foremost, you know that plants prepare food in the form of glucose, okay? Now this glucose is stored in the plants in the form of starch. Now to test starch, always iodine solution is used. This iodine is actually a non-metal, okay? This iodine is actually a non-metal which converts the starch into a blue-black color, okay? So the purpose of iodine is that it converts this starch into a blue-black color, which indicates that starch is present. Means starch is, if starch is present in the leaf, that means food was prepared by the plant, and when iodine was put, that turned into a blue-black color. Thus, this is the positive test for starch or a carbohydrate, that food is prepared during the process of photosynthesis. Now, remember, if you are asked a question that what is the chemical which is used to test the presence of starch in leaves, so it is iodine solution, okay, and iodine is a non-metal. Iodine is a non-metal which is solid at room temperature. It appears a bit purplish black in color, okay. So this is all about the activity, and a conclusion has been also given in the book that it means that leaf has food or carbohydrate, that is starch, in it. Thus it can be concluded that green leaves make their food in the presence of sunlight and green colored pigment called chlorophyll present in them. For this they use water and carbon dioxide from the air. This process is known as photosynthesis. Oxygen is given out in this process. The food prepared by the leaves ultimately gets stored in the different parts of the plant as starch. So glucose is produced, but glucose is converted into a starch and is stored in the different parts of the plant. Children, one thing very important about photosynthesis which you should remember, that carbon dioxide is used for photosynthesis and oxygen is given out during the process of photosynthesis. Okay, don't write the opposite one, because in higher classes you have another process which is known as respiration, where you have to where the opposite happens. Okay, in respiration oxygen is taken and carbon dioxide is given out. Here in photosynthesis, what carbon dioxide is taken in for photosynthesis and oxygen is given out. Okay. Okay, let us go to the next slide. Now in activity 4, what we see in activity 4, it is the process of transpiration. Yesterday also I got one question that, ma'am, how does transpiration occur? Now how this transpiration occur, how we can understand this, okay? Now the experiment has been performed here. To study the process of transpiration in leaves, method, a small potted plant is taken, okay? You can see potted plant, that is the soil is there and everything is there. Cover it with a transparent polythene bag in such a way that its mouth tie around the base of the stem. Keep this setup under the sun for few hours. After some time, observe the inner surface of the bag. But you will see, now children, very important thing which you will need for higher classes also in class 10, that see, the polythene bag has not been tied along with the pot. Okay, it has been tied at the base of the stem. That is very important. Sometimes questions are asked that why the polythene is tied at the base of the stem and not along with the pot. Okay, so when we go through this next part of the slide, we'll understand why it is tied. Okay, observation. You will see small droplets of water on the inner side of the bag. On the inner side of the bag, you can see some droplets of water. From where did these droplets appear in the bag? Can you make any guess? Conclusion drawn. Water comes out of the leaves in the form of vapor by the process of transpiration. This suggests that plants release a lot of water into the air through this process. You will learn about this process in the higher classes. Now, see, if it is tied at the base, this polythene bag is tied at the base of the stem. So we can understand that the water which is coming out inside the bag, the droplets of water, is coming from nowhere but from the plant itself. Okay. But if we would have tied the polythene along with the pot, okay, along with the pot, at the base of the pot we would have tied it, then what would happen? The soil also contains water in which the plant is rooted. Okay. The soil also contains water. So that soil water might have evaporated and accumulated in the polythene. So that is the reason we don't take the pot, we are only tying it at the base of the stem, okay, of the plant. This is clear. This is the process of transpiration. So those water droplets which we see on the inner side of the polythene bag, those are actually a result of the process of transpiration, okay. Now we'll come to the exercise. Now in the exercise, children, I'll deal only with the objective ones today, okay? Short answer questions, long answer questions, and choose the odd one out, I'll deal with in the next video lesson. Now first and foremost, name the following. The entire set of leaves in a plant is known as its foliage, okay? F-O-L-I-A-G-E. The order in which leaves grow on the plant, that is acropetal order. I showed you a video also that the younger leaves are towards its apex, the growing apex, and the older leaves are towards its base. Sharp pointed organs present for the purpose of defense are spines. Okay. Stalk by which leaf lamina is attached to the main stem, which is known as the petiole. Leaves in which lamina is divided into small segments attached to the petiole, it is known as the compound leaf. The angle between the petiole and the stem is known as the axil. Okay. Let us come to the fill in the blanks. The stalk by which the leaf lamina is attached to the main stem is known as the petiole. So I have written only the answers here. Okay. The angle between the petiole and the stem is called axil. Okay. The end of the petiole joining the stem is known as the leaf base. Number fourth, veins divide and subdivide to form a network of veinlets. Okay. If the venations run parallel to the midrib, it is called parallel venation. Number sixth, the arrangement of leaves on the nodes of the stem and branches is known as phyllotaxy. Okay. Now write true or false. What we see in true or false, I have written only the answers, and you have to correct the statements also. So I have written the correction part also there. So the first question is, parallel venation are found in the leaves of dicot plants. Okay, parallel venation is found in the leaves of monocot plants. So the statement is false, and you have to cut dicot and you have to write monocot there. Okay. Now second question, In case of Venus fly trap, lamina becomes modified into a pitcher to capture insects. So this is false, and pitcher is formed in Venus fly trap or in pitcher plant. So it is pitcher plant, so you have to cut Venus fly trap and you have to write pitcher there. Okay, the next question which is given is, the leaves of Nepenthes is broad and has notches at its margin. Okay, now we know that the notches at the margin where epiphyllous buds are there, it is present in bryophyllum. So this is a false statement, and we have to cut Nepenthes and we have to write bryophyllum there. Number four, leaves are modified to spines to reduce water loss. This is true. Rhizobium is a insectivorous plant. False. Nepenthes or any other insectivorous like Venus flytrap also you can write. So I have written Nepenthes. It is pitcher plant. Okay. Nepenthes is a insect, is an insectivorous plant. The lowermost, next one. The lowermost leaves are small, young, and bright green. It is false. The uppermost leaves, you will cut lowermost and you will write uppermost leaves are small, young, and bright green. Okay. Choose the correct answer. The point at which leaf is attached to the stem is known as node. Okay, the point at which the leaf is attached is known as the node. The part of the leaf in contact with the stem at the node is known as the leaf base. Flattened, thin, green, and broad outgrowth of the stem is known as the leaf. Leaves in which lamina is divided into small segments is known as compound leaf. Number fifth. If three or more leaves are borne at each node, the arrangement is called whorled. Okay, whorled phyllotaxy. And number six, Venus flytrap is an example of. It is an example of what? Insectivorous plant. Okay. Now come to match the following. Monocots. Monocots is the numbers which I have written a bit hazy. So match it and write down in your books. Okay. Monocots. Monocots. It will be parallel venation. Okay. Monocots. Parallel venation. Number one. Number two, leaf blade. Leaf blade will be which one? Lamina. Okay. Leaf blade will be joined with lamina. Now, rose. Number three. Rose is will be matching with compound leaf. Okay. It doesn't have simple leaf. It has compound leaf. Dicots. Number four. Number four, dicots will be reticulate venation. Number A. Okay. Column B, number A. That is reticulate venation. Dicots, reticulate venation. Number five, people. People leaf is which type of leaf? It is a simple leaf. Okay. Stalk, number six. Stalk is petiole. Okay. It will match with petiole. Okay. Now define the following terms. You have defined the following terms. I have also written the answers. Now, what do you mean by phyllotaxy? The arrangement of leaves on the nodes of the stem and branches is known as phyllotaxy. So the manner in which they are arranged on the stem and branches, it is known as phyllotaxy. There are three types. You know, that is alternate phyllotaxy. This one opposite and bold. In case of alternate, there is only one leaf on the node. In case of opposite, there are two leaves at each node. And in case of bold phyllotaxy, there are three leaves on each node. Okay, so this is all about phyllotaxy. Phyllode. Now, phyllode, what we know, that when the petiole, we know that petiole is a thin stalk. Okay, but when the petiole becomes expanded into a flat green leaf like photosynthetic structure, it is called the phyllode. Okay, so the petiole becomes flat, the leaf is lost. In some plants, the leaf might be in the form of small leaflets, as I had shown when I was showing the video. I had shown that in the phyllode some small leaflets were there at the tip, okay, but the petiole actually here, the petiole, the leaf, actual leaf is not there, but the petiole becomes expanded into a green flat photosynthetic structure, leaf like photosynthetic structure, which is known as the phyllode. Transpiration, loss of water from the plants in the form of water vapor through tiny openings, which is known as stomata. Okay, so this is known as transpiration. Epiphyllous buds, we know the example of epiphyllous buds in which plant is present in bryophyllum. Okay, so when buds arise on the leaves, they are called epiphyllous buds. Lastly, venation, the arrangement of midrib veins and veinlets in a leaf is known as venation. And we studied about what type of venations, children? Two types of venations, reticulate venation and parallel venation. What we saw in reticulate venation, that it had a web-like structure. The veins and veinlets form a web-like structure. It forms a network. But in case of parallel venation, there was no network. And the veins and veinlets, they run parallel to each other. Okay. So, and one more difference we saw about reticulate and parallel venation. That reticulate venation is found in dicots. And parallel venation is found in monocots. Okay, so this is a very important question which you need to understand. Okay, some of the important questions, internal questions, I'll just tell you verbally, children. Just mark it in your books. Okay, acropetal order might be asked. What do you mean by acropetal order? Okay. Then what are the different parts of the leaf? Leaf blade, the lamina, stalk or petiole, and the leaf base. Okay, this might be asked. Now, what is the function of petiole? What is the function of lamina? These things might be asked. Okay. Now, then what is the difference between reticulate and parallel venation? I have already told you in the video lessons also, very important. That is this part, difference between simple leaf and compound leaves. Okay, is a very important question again. Phyllotaxy, name the three types of phyllotaxy: opposite, alternate, and bold phyllotaxy, and also the examples you have to learn. Match the following might be given. Okay, children, general functions of the leaf might be asked separately, so you have to write the according to the marks. You have to write what are the different types of leaves, what are the different functions of leaves. Okay, now one more question I told about iodine test, that is starch test, which is done with which chemical? Starch, which is produced in the leaf, is tested with iodine. Okay, now short notes on leaf tendrils, spines, phyllode, hooks, scale leaves, pitcher plant, pitcher, Venus flytrap, bladder might be given. Functions or why in cactus plant there are the leaves are modified into spines, that might also be given. Okay, why leaves are modified into spines, that might be given, which is given in the book in activity 6. It helps to survive in hot, dry climate. How it helps? Because it reduces the amount of transpiration, so water is reserved. Now it protects the plant from grazing animals also. Short note on vegetative propagation in leaves also can be given. What do you mean by vegetative? Vegetative means when reproduction takes place with the help of vegetative parts of the plant, that is leaves, stems, roots, etc., then it is known as vegetative propagation of leaves. Okay, children, so I'll be back with a new video lesson very soon, children, and I'll be discussing questions, the short answer questions, the long answer questions, and choose the onward out very soon. Okay, so till then, thank you.